Welcome to episode 16 of A Message From. We're your hosts. I'm Allison.
I'm Edward.
And drumroll, please.
Drumroll, please.
It is the Eurovision episode.
It is. I'm so excited. But we can't really talk about it until the bottom half.
Right. True.
So we decided on something else for the top half.
Yes. Recommendations.
Recs, what we're currently consuming.
That's a good way to put it, what we're currently consuming.
Right. Maybe I won't recommend these for everybody, but this is what I'm doing.
Precisely.
Yeah.
Precisely. So what do you want to start with?
Yeah, we have four categories, I think, that we broke things into. We have books, TV/movies, music/podcasts. So I guess that's three categories.
Yeah, three.
Yeah. What do you want to start with first? I'll let your choice. Dealer's choice.
Okay, let's start with books.
Books. I did just buy some books in New York.
I did buy some books in New York. I told you all about those.
Uh-huh.
I'm currently reading L'Elegance du Hérisson. Alex sent it to me.
Oh, there we go.
I'm not too far into it yet, but it's good so far. It's basically about, this concierge that lives and works in this really fancy building in France, in Paris, and then kind of, the interactions with a family and, one specific girl who lives in that building.
Interesting. Who's the author?
Muriel Barbary, I think.
Oh, okay. I'm just curious.
Yeah, I hadn't heard of her before.
I don't read too much in French, so, not for any reason other than the fact that I just don't do it.
Yeah. My goal this year, part of my reading goal this year was to read 4 books in French.
Oh, that's good. How many books in total was your reading goal? I know we talked about it ages ago.
35.
35, that's a lot of books.
I'm behind schedule, too.
It is a lot. Very behind schedule as well.
Very behind.
Yeah. But summer's coming up, and that's generally when I get to read a bit more.
Mm-hmm. Was your goal 24?
Yeah, it's double. 2 a month.
Yeah.
So, we're quite behind. But I'm also kind of reading, 3 books at the same time. Well, that's kind of a lie. But, yeah. Books for me, I just said, I think, a couple weeks in the pod, La Peste by Albert Camus.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I'm reading. And it's good. I really like it.
I do need to read that.
There's just some pages, though, where it's just full description. And it's just ooh. Skippy. Well, not Skippy, I read, but it's Skippy if I don't understand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's going to happen.
Yeah. I also did have to look up, a spark notes of the character list so I could remember who was who. Because, a lot of people in this book.
That's what I had to do when I first started Les Mis. Because
I forgot. Did you read that in French?
No, so I read it in English, but I read, the unabridged version and, the long, droning descriptions of, the political situation and stuff.
Right.
I mean, interesting, of course, but it was sad. There were times where I was like, this is a lot.
Yeah. That's a classic, isn't it? It's considered a classic.
Yeah.
And I feel like, obviously, those are, when I think of Les Mis, I think of, oh my god, excuse me, I'm dying. When I think of Les Mis, I think of books similar to Les Mis, classics that I had to read in high school, and I fully spark noted.
Oh my gosh. When we had to read classics in high school, I hated those books.
I know.
I couldn't stand any of them. I think it was because we were, forced to read them, maybe.
Probably.
I'm wondering if I would like some of them now if I read them again.
I did enjoy, The Crucible. I don't know if you've ever read that one. But that was a play.
I can't remember if I was in the class that read The Crucible or not.
For us, it was American Literature Year. So I don't know.
We had... Because there were different reading lists between, the advanced placement... And then the regular classes. And I know one of them read The Crucible. I remember my friends talking about it. But for some reason, I don't think I read The Crucible.
I don't remember what happens. I just remember I really liked it. And I was surprised because it was like a summer reading list. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Do you have anything else on books? I know. I feel like for what we're consuming, it's, I mean, books is just like one at a time.
Yeah. Well, I did just finish Year of Yes by Shonda Rhimes, and that was really good.
Oh,
I'm usually like a solely fiction person, but lately I've been getting more into non-fiction. Like memoirs.
Oh, memoir. Love.
It's a memoir. And it was really good. It was a great book.
Yeah.
So I would highly recommend that.
Sorry.
Continue. No, I was just going to say, I really recommend that to anyone who,
okay.
You know.
I finished also like Broken People, but that was like 2 months ago. By Sam Lansky. And I'm on La Peste by Albert Camus. And I read The Attached, about attachment theory. I read that book also in January. Very good. But that's really, been on a slow roll.
Yeah.
What about TV movies? What's going on with you there?
TV movies. Still watching Suburra.
Oh my god, a Suburra update. I mean, think about it.
Yes. How's it going? Good. Wait, it's going really
what
well.
What season are you on?
I'm still on season one.
Okay,
it's going very
slowly. Season 3 yet.
It's so obviously I'm reading the subtitles. Like there are some people where I'm like, yes, I totally understand you, and then other people where I'm like, have I been trying to learn Italian for the last 2 years or not?
Yeah, I totally get that. I totally get that.
And then there's like the one family that switches into Roma. Is that what they speak? Roma?
Romanian, or I'm not sure what it's called. I don't remember. Zingaro or something like that, right?
Yeah. It's like they switch into a different language, and so then
it's like a dialect of, it's like a, yeah.
Yeah. And,
they do. I forgot about that.
And each episode is fully like an hour long, right? Or like 56 minutes or something.
Yeah, I remember them being long.
So it's a lot. They're long episodes. I'm obviously like concentrating on the subtitles. It's a great show.
It's good, isn't it? It's really good.
It's really good, but it's taking me time to get through it.
But understandable.
I'm just like, I feel like I've heard, I guess not directly from like people that I talk to all the time, but I feel like there's a lot of people have like a hesitancy to watch shows in a different language because they don't want to like focus on the subtitles and stuff.
Because they don't want
to
read.
Yeah. Lazy. But I'm like,
I get sometimes depending on what you're doing while you're watching.
Exactly. If you're doing something else or you just need something in the background, like that's not the show for you. But some of the absolute best things I've ever watched have been in languages I don't understand at all.
Yeah. I agree.
So, I like, obviously, I'm trying to learn Italian, so that's a big draw for me for this show. Like, that's kind of, like, why I started watching it to begin with. Mm-hmm. Even though it's a really great show, and if I, you know, if I wasn't trying to learn Italian, I could see myself watching this anyway, just because it's a great show.
It's, like, the best of both worlds.
Yeah. So, but that's what I'm trying to say, is, like, even if you're not trying to learn Italian or French or Korean or whatever, like, there are some incredible shows that are available to watch.
Yeah, I think people should give foreign produced content more of a shot.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
I did just finish The Circle US, which on topics of things that we've talked about on the pod, loved.
Yes.
But I don't necessarily recommend if you don't want to watch it.
I mean, like, it's just like, it's fun
really
reality
into it if
TV.
You're into it.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Reality TV. But I also, right before The Circle came out, I was watching a lot of like anime, not anime, but like cartoon shows. That's different. Sorry. They were like fully just cartoon.
Okay.
Like shows. I'm trying to go through my watch list here. I have an app that I used and it's not loading.
Have ever watched anime.
I mean, I've watched anime before. It's very good. Usually the episodes are like 30 minutes or less, which I love. But I just watched one about like Pacific Rim. Did you ever see that movie? There's like two movies.
No, I didn't see it.
Yeah. Well, I did. I liked them. I had to watch one for like a Hispanic comics course in my senior year. It was really random. That was one of the best things we did that whole semester. But anyway, since I saw that there was like a show, I watched it in like one night because it was like 6 episodes, 30 minutes long. I was like, sure. But I've also just been consuming a lot of Drag Race.
Love Drag Race.
It's never ending.
It is never ending. There's so, and now there, well, you know, there's the UK and then there's Australia and there's, it's just everywhere. And there's so many seasons and it's a little lot.
So that's really all I've been doing. I need to watch Drag Race Thailand. I need to watch this week's episode of Down Under. And yeah. Oh, and I need to watch Posed. Have you seen Pose?
No.
Oh, you would love Pose. Highly recommend Pose.
I wonder where I could find that.
FX. I think the third season's on HBO here. I'm not really sure, though. Yeah. Anyway. Anything else you've been watching recently? You said you watched Baby. You said you watched Suburra. You're watching Suburra, sorry.
I mean, just obviously Formula One.
Oh, right. And you're consuming a lot of Formula One.
Consuming a lot.
I haven't really had too many updates about it from you. I kind of forgot it was happening.
I, like, bombarded you last season. Yeah. But it was a lot. It was a lot. I apologize. But it's it's only the fourth race this year.
How many races are there?
A lot. It goes through December.
Oh.
She had a long season. There's like 23 races. I think the FIA contract that they're under allows them to max out at like 25 races.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this year there's 23. But they're in Spain this weekend.
That's right. We did talk about this off pod briefly before we started recording. Yeah. It is. It's in Barcelona, I think you said.
Barcelona. It's in Barcelona. I think when this episode goes live, that'll be Monaco Grand Prix week.
Oh, it is that time of year.
Mm-hmm. You remember when we were there, they had like the stands and everything set up and they were starting to set up the track.
Yeah, everything was starting to get set up. Yeah. I remember. Mm-hmm. Why were we there at that time?
I think we were just like hanging out in Monaco for a day.
We must have been doing a walk.
Probably doing a walk to the beach or something.
We were probably walking to Cap d'Ai.
Yeah. That was really the only reason we went to Monaco.
Yeah, or like if someone was visiting, we would go.
Yeah, we would take, anytime anyone visited, we would take them to Monaco.
Yeah. And I was like, I don't think anyone visited that late.
Probably not, no.
Yeah.
No. I mean, that was just our beach time, anyway.
True. Oh, the beach time.
That was a great time.
Oh, but remember that little sandy beach, the little tiny little beach right by my house? Sandy beach. I think about it all the time.
Same.
Oh.
Those were like our best days.
Oh, best life. That was like, we spent, what, 6 months waiting for those like 2 weeks?
Yeah, honestly.
Yeah.
Kicking cinna, eating it on the balcony, on the patio. I have to go to the beach all day.
That like one bedroom apartment that I had.
When I basically just like moved in for the last 2 weeks.
Yeah. You did we share a bed or did you sleep on the couch?
I think because there was the couch, the trundle, and the bed. I think I slept on the couch.
Yeah. That's right. Wow, I completely forgot. I'm like tis the season to reminisce on that time.
Reminisce, yeah.
Oh, I would do anything to have a mustard bowl salad.
A mustard bowl salad with you on a terrace in France.
My God.
In the sun.
Me going to that super casino to get
that
a...
That super casino was my 99 fire. Cent
macaroni.
That was an incredible casino.
It was.
All the ones by me were small, but there was a really good Carrefour by me.
Oh, yeah. I walked by a Carrefour today, actually, and I thought immediately of you in France and Carrefour. I don't know why.
I could do damage there.
Yeah. Yeah. That and a Monoprix. Anyway,
we got way off track. I mean, we were talking about, like, book recommendations and, like, movie recommendations, and now we're talking about grocery stores in France.
Oh, my God. It's classic us.
Yeah.
We love it. Well, we only have one more category. Are you listening to anything special?
I don't know music. How to say that. Special.
We don't really talk about music, the two of us, very often.
No. I don't know if we can call it special, but I'm still like on my, like, UK hip-hop and rap kick.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that you were into that.
It's been lasting, like, a lot longer than I thought it would. But,
It's interesting. It's interesting.
It's interesting. And not too long ago, actually, my autographed copy of AJ Tracy's album arrived.
You sent that to me fully expecting me to know what the hell you were talking about, and I was so confused.
Surprise. So
you're like, it's finally arrived, and I was like, what is this?
One of my favorite UK artists, AJ Tracy, just came out with a new album, and so obviously, like, he obviously does a lot of self-promotion. I don't think he has, like, a record label. I don't think he's, like, signed to a label, which is interesting because for so long the music industry, like, you couldn't do anything if you weren't signed to a label. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's self-represented. So obviously he's been doing tons of promotion, and it was, like, all his Instagram videos and everything. He's, like, signing all his albums and his CDs and everything, and, like, some of them had, like, fun special messages on them, and I'm like, let me just look at the price of this. Let me order one of these. This is a collector's item.
It is. It is.
So,
how much was it expensive?
No. Okay. So here's the thing. It wasn't expensive at all. It was like $12, but the shipping was just as much as the dang album.
Yeah, that'll get it. That'll get you.
That'll get me. But anyway, I spent like $23. No big deal.
It's actually not that bad.
No. So it arrives in my mailbox. I'm excited. I love it. I'm loving it. And then I'm like, I literally don't even have a CD player. I bought this.
I didn't even think about that.
Autographed CD. And I'm like,
you're never going to be able to play it.
My car doesn't have a CD player in it. My laptop doesn't have, like, a disc drive thing in it anymore. Those aren't things. No. I do have an old Blu-ray player that I could put it in.
You have a Blu-ray player?
Yeah, honestly, where? I've been thinking about getting rid of this thing for years. Because I'm like, when am I ever going to freaking use it? I use it on occasion to watch my Harry Potter DVDs.
Oh, because they're not on Netflix or something?
I mean, they're on TV like every weekend. It doesn't even matter. Oh, I could watch them anywhere. US.
Yeah.
And then occasionally, I will use it to watch my... Speaking of music, here's another one. My music taste is just, like, wild, off the charts, all over the place. But I have this Avenged Sevenfold live show disc live in the LBC. And it's just, like, their best performance ever, truly, like, their best performance of all time, all recorded on this DVD, and every so often I'll watch that as well.
Okay.
I used to be super into, like, metal and screamo and stuff.
If this does not surprise me, surprisingly. Not surprising. Okay. All right.
Yeah, so what are you listening to?
Well, I was going to say, most of the stuff that I'm listening to currently, it's just Eurovision songs, which is perfect because we got to take a break and get into it.
Yes, Eurovision coming up next. Okay, welcome back from the break. We are ready to get into Eurovision fun. We have a message from Natalie regarding
another
Eurovision.
Another message from Natalie.
So we'll play that for y'all now.
Hey, just wanted to see what the thoughts were on Eurovision 2021. I'm thinking heaters. Wondering what the pod is thinking. Thanks.
No, thank you for calling in a message. We appreciate it.
We absolutely love. We love. We love. We love. I also want to say that I love that she called us AMP. It took me a while to figure out what it meant, but it means a message from. Love that.
It took me a second too, but I was like, we need a nickname.
Yeah, that's like fun. I like that. But Eurovision. Back to the meat of the message.
Yes.
What's your experience with Eurovision?
So, Eurovision obviously is not very popular in the U.S.
Not at all.
And, like, I know about Eurovision. I know what it is. I know what happens every year. I know that people go, like, wild for it in, like, Europe and Australia and Iceland and all that. And Eurovision's great. I mean, they helped launch ABBA. Eurovision?
Yeah.
You like it? We have to thank Eurovision for a lot. But the thing that I can, like, compare it to the most, I guess, it makes me think back to the early days of American Idol. Because
it has those vibes, yeah.
It was like, I was in middle school at that time, I think. And it was like, everyone was in front of their TV. Like, the first couple seasons of American Idol, everyone was in front of their TV watching. And you still had to, like, call in your votes. I remember running upstairs to the kitchen to, like, grab that telephone off the wall and call in my vote for Fantasia Barrino. And then the next day in school, I think it probably did cost money. Like, yeah, sorry, mom and dad, called into American Idol. And then, like, the next day in school, everyone will be talking about it.
And yes, true.
Like, I've heard comparisons of Eurovision to, like, a cross between, like, American Idol and the Olympics.
Yeah, it's like the Super Bowl, the Olympics, and American Idol. All in one.
Because it's got that, like, competition between countries, but then obviously it's like all performance and music based. And
I think a lot of people don't realize that it's technically a song contest. So like, while the there's two halves of the vote, it's like the popular vote and like the jury vote, and like people always be surprised when certain songs like make the higher ranks after the jury vote, but it's because of like the song itself. Like, obviously the performance can be boring or like not as fun or like super fun, and it can rank differently because of the song itself. Maybe people forget that.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah,
I did.
But anyway, as you were saying, that was a random side.
I did like a really quick search on the history of Eurovision, because obviously, like I said, I know what it is, but I didn't really know like when it started, the history. Started in 1956.
Yes, it did.
It was based on the San Remo Music Festival. Did you know this? Which
we love. Do you know this festival?
Remo Music Festival. San Remo was like really close to where we were when we lived in France. That was like one of the places you could easily get to on a train in Italy.
Yeah, we definitely were on a train at one point that stopped in San Remo. Yeah. Do you know about San Remo though?
No.
It's how Italy selects their Eurovision contestant.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. Yes.
And it happened in February, I think, this year. Regardless, I love San Remo because I always get good music out of it. Such good music. Sorry.
Okay, I need to start paying attention to this because I've been trying to like listen to more Italian music.
Oh my god. Italian music is so good. People are sleeping on Italian music. Sorry. I'm very passionate about this. Continue.
I've definitely been sleeping on Italian music because I have like a few songs here or there that I listen to that I've somehow stumbled across on, you know, Spotify or something else, but I'm not in the know.
No, and I'm thinking, my friend Natalie actually and I have been thinking of a way for us to somehow get people into the know. So something, it's in the pipeline. What's the phrase?
Yeah.
It's in the pipeline. Nothing's coming soon, but we're thinking about it. Because people need to know. Because it is, like, chef kiss, divine.
People do need to know. I need to know. Send that pipeline my way.
Right, directly your way.
Directly my way. In those underwater cables.
Oh, don't even get me started on the underwater cables. I can't. We talked about this, like, last time we recorded. after Off the Pod, and it was shocking to me.
I thought everyone knew about the underwater cables.
I did, but also didn't, if that makes any sense.
Yeah. But anyway, back to Eurovision.
Back to Eurovision.
Yeah. So we've already established, like, I have a basic knowledge of Eurovision. I kind of, like, know what the main idea is, know what it's about. But up until, gosh, was it last year or the year before? It wasn't, like, easy to access in the U.S.
No, it generally isn't. I think it's VH1 not, had it for a bit.
Yeah, so it was never broadcast in the U.S., but then...
But you can watch online on the Eurovision website.
Yeah.
The live
feed. But like I said, was it last year or the year before? Logo, which obviously is like partnered with VH1.
Right.
Broadcast
yes.
it. And I'm like, Logo is truly doing the Lord's work.
They are.
They bring us RuPaul's Drag Race.
Yeah, they do.
Now they bring us Eurovision.
They also Logo. Brought us Prince Charming or whatever.
Oh.
The gay bachelor show? Terrible.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, though, like, I don't have Logo because I don't have cable. I just do Hulu.
Right.
I do Hulu with, like, the live TV option, but obviously the channel options are very limited.
Yeah.
So I don't have Logo.
Yeah, I don't have it either. But I don't live in the U.S., I don't know who's broadcasting it this year, if it's being broadcasted. Do you know?
I have no idea.
Neither do I. I haven't even figured out how I'm going to watch it yet this year, if I'll do the live feed or if I'll find a TV. Because I also have to deal with, like, Spanish commentary, and sometimes I'm just like, I don't want to deal with that.
Yeah.
I don't want to deal with that commentary. Speaking of Spain, their entry sucks.
I was going to ask who you're supporting this year.
I was trying to think of my top three. And there are a lot of songs I love, a lot. But, like, my top, I think my top this year is Greece.
Well, of course. It's Greece.
Well, you would think, of course, it's Greece. But not always great.
We're channeling, though. Like, this is the year of the Greek for
yes,
us.
Yes, it is the year of the Greek. Get him to the Greek. Get us to the Greek.
Get us to the Greek.
Yeah. So let me play a clip for you to see how good this song is. This is why it's my number one. And controversial because Cyprus is also my number one, but I think this one takes the cake. Like, it edges Cyprus out a little bit. If our hearts are hanging on a wire, let's forget the world.
That's so good.
It's so good. Right?
Wow.
Yeah. She's my number one. I wrote down okay voice, okay song, okay goosebumps, okay Greek mythology. Because Pegasus flies out of nowhere in this
thing. Stefania.
Yes, Stefania. Last Dance. I think she's my number one. Yeah. But my number two, and this is where it gets difficult, because I already knew what the Italy one was. Because of Sanremo, and I knew that they won, and I like their song a lot, but I think I like Cyprus more. So let's watch Cyprus.
Let's watch Cyprus. Because that's obviously your second choice, but you just don't want to, like, betray Italy, which I understand.
Yeah, and Italy's is good. Italy's is good. It's, like, up there for me as well. France, boring also. I mean, beautiful, but boring. Okay, this is Cyprus.
Honestly, like... I'm sorry, but is that not France? Like, beautiful but boring?
Oh, 100% France. Beautiful but boring. 100%. Okay. Put on the set of shot and the bodies. The taco, the male. Yeah, that's my more. Only spicy melts my eyes. The edges, baby, it's true. Tonight we're gonna burn in a party. It's heaven and hell with you. Mama, mama, see the, tell me what to do. Do la, lo, la, lo. I'm breaking the rules. I feel love, I gave my heart to El Diablo, El Diablo.
Okay, El Diablo.
I know.
Love
right?
it's
like, it's Cypress always does a really good job. Ever since Fuego came out with Eleni, that was like 3-4 years ago, I want to say. They've just been so good.
Oh my gosh. Good.
I know. We love. So they're like my number two. But then I also really like Italy. And that one is by Manskin. Oh, sorry. What was... Cypress's was El Diablo by Elena Zagrino?
Zagrino?
Yeah. That yours sounded better than mine did. But this one's Italy's.
Signore e signori, fuori gli attori, vi conviene toccarvi coglioni, vi conviene stare zitti e buoni, qui la gente è strana tipo spacciatori, troppe notti stavo chiuso fuori, mo li prendo a calci sti portoni, sguardo in alto tipo scalatori, quindi scusa mamma se sono sempre fuori, ma sono fuori di te.
Oh my gosh.
It's good. And I think it's that it would be so higher good. Up for me. Like, I think it would edge out Cyprus, but not Greece. Sorry, Greece is still my number one.
But I think it,
I just like, I've
one.
Been listening for so long now that it's not as exciting.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
That makes sense. I feel like that kind of sets them up almost for a little bit of failure because there's overexposure. Like, everyone will have.
Oh no. That's just, I mean, personally for me. All of these have been out for a long time. I only know about this one for a while because I was paying attention to Sanremo. And I knew about the Spain one for a while, too, but it sucks.
I mean, no, this is so good. And I feel like what might give them an edge over maybe Greece or Cyprus is, I feel like, even though, don't get me wrong, Greece and Cyprus both are incredible and, like, fun, and they pick so up and they good. Get upbeat and they're catchy. But I feel like it's also kind of what you typically expect of, like, a song competition. Yeah. It's, like, this beautiful, tight, like, scantily clad, dressed woman singing this, like, poppy music.
Oh, yeah, which, for sure.
And no issues always, with like, that at all.
There's like, always a few... There's always, like, a hardcore, like, rock one. Mm-hmm. And then there's, like, a... Like, there's one that's even more hardcore than the one we just listened to. And then... But, like, there's always, like, a few that, like, color the very... what's the word I'm looking for? Like, poppy landscape of the competition. I will play... Let's play Francis next.
Okay.
So you can see that one. The beautiful but boring... the Italian one was called Zitti e Buoni.
Zitti e Buoni.
Yeah. And this one is Barbara Pravi singing Voila.
This is the most French thing I've ever heard. Yeah. Her name is Barbara and she's singing a song called Voila.
Moi ce que je veux, c'est écrire des histoires qui arrivent jusqu'à vous. C'est tout. J'ai peur, oui, me voilà dans le bruit et dans le silence. Regardez-moi.
Okay, I can't anymore.
Okay. Beautiful, perfect for like a sad rainy day, which is what it is here, but she can't go after anyone. If she goes first, they might do okay. Yeah.
The
but
slow like, ones are like, they're always kind of like... Okay, I'm going to watch this.
If she goes after any of the first three we listened to, France is done.
Yeah, I don't even know what the lineup will be because it also depends on the semifinals, who makes it to the grand final during the week. We'll have to see. And then the last one I think we'll play. So yeah, oh no, one that I do like, and then we'll end on one that I'm hate. Ireland, I really like, but it's also very upbeat, like you had said before. Mm-hmm. It's like Maps by Leslie Roy, and I thought it was just good. I don't know why.
Run, stay, colors in the gray. Thought I was done, but I got it wrong. I felt twice, I'm
like a great girl power anthem.
It's very good. Like, it's just, it's very anthem-y. And I tend to really like those songs. But a lot of, and let's play the one. Let's play the one that I probably hate the most.
España.
Spain's. Blas Canto, and it is Voy a Quedarme, and it is, they are not even pretending to win. they're trying to lose their permanent position in the grand final.
Oh my god.
Oh, here we go. He bajado el cielo para descubrir que se esconde en tu mirada solo unos centímetros de mí. Voy a quedarme, prometo quererte más que ayer. Voy a besarte muy lento como la primera vez y dejar atrás el miedo con tu alma entre mis dedos. Quédate porque yo voy a quedarte.
Last Canto, I'm sorry. No. Are you trying to drag everyone down? We just lived through a whole pandemic. And this is what you come out with?
It's not great. It's not great.
It's like drowning in a puddle of tears on the floor.
I know. It's like so emo. Like emotional emo. I will say like other ones that I enjoyed were like Australia's and like San Marino's. I love. But, and Norway's I really like a lot, too. There are a lot that I like. But I've heard people really like also as well, like, Czech Republic, I think it was.
I'm going to need to listen to all of these.
Oh, no, Croatia. Sorry, TikTok. People like that one as well. But I haven't really dug too much into, like, the, like, speculation or, like, the predictions and things like that. Yeah. It's not really how I view your, like, not how I enjoy Eurovision. I end up just, like, liking things I like, hoping they'll win, and then I pay the vote. Because I live in Spain and I could do that. I love that.
Isn't that incredible?
I'm so excited. I'm also manifesting like Greece to win because then they'll host it the year after. And I need to go. I need to go to Eurovision very soon in general, but like.
You do.
Let's just say I'm not super looking. I wouldn't be dying to go to Rotterdam, but no. I would die to go to Athens or but any other city in Greece.
Die to go to Greece.
Yeah.
We need to include the link to this site that you're using to share with everyone else because that's great. And everyone's going to want to listen to these songs. I mean, obviously not Spain.
No, not that one. And a few other ones. Others. There was one that I wrote, I think Bulgaria's, I wrote boring. Germany, I wrote what the fuck, but okie dokie.
Honestly, can I tell you, that's literally what I... how I would react to any German song.
It was in English. Most of these songs are in English.
Right, but I just mean like
yeah,
German pop culture and like music and like I just think of the most wild things.
Yeah, it is. I don't know too much, but what I imagine is it's not on my alley.
WTF, but okie dokie.
But okie dokie work. That's what I wrote. Okie dokie work. I will also say that the San Marino one has a feature on it from an American rapper. Would you like to take a wild guess as to who is featured on the...
Kanye?
No. You need to think not as like A-list. Kanye's very A-list celebrity. We're going down. I mean... this person's very famous, I think.
Is it like more old school or like early 2000s or new school?
We were absolutely bumping to this music in the early 2000s or like late aughts.
Not Ja Rule.
No, it's not Ja Rule.
I feel like he's trying so hard to make a comeback and he's just failing miserably. Nelly.
Not Nelly. I'll give you one more. This is going to blow your mind.
One more. It's going to blow my mind. Genuine.
Flo Rida.
Flo Rida. I love Flo Rida. Oh my gosh.
I'm curious as to if he's going to be at the performance or not. I kind of think he won't, but at the same time, I wouldn't be surprised.
That'd be incredible. I mean, what else is he doing?
True. In a pan, in the panorama. I don't know what he's doing.
In this panorama.
Yeah. So that's our Eurovision episode. I'm super excited. Some of these songs are absolute bangers. And I really hope Greece wins. And, or Cyprus. Or Italy.
Or Italy. Or Italy's was such a banger.
Italy's was good. Very good. They have good music in general, that band. You should take a look at them.
I'm going to check them out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Obviously it will depend on the performances as well. That, like, plays a big factor. So, I'm just excited. I'm just super excited. That's all I can say.
I'm excited, too, and I never watch it.
Oh, my God. Are you going to watch this year?
I'm going to watch this year.
It is on a Saturday. The grand final.
That's perfect, because with the time difference, I feel like that'll be easy. It won't, like, be in the middle of my day.
No. Yeah, because it'll be, like, 8 o'clock my time. All right. But that's it for today. I hope that helped. We'll obviously put a link to that website I was looking at in the show notes. And probably to a Spotify playlist, just to, like, make it easy.
Hopefully this inspires everyone to get into Eurovision.
Ugh, if you're not paying attention to Eurovision... And also Italian music. You're behind. You're behind.
Get with it.
Get with the program. You could also get with the program by sending us a message to messagefrompostcards@gmail.com or 202-630-4509 if you're in the U.S. And rate, review, subscribe, tell a friend, tell a family member, and watch Eurovision on May 22nd. Yes.
See you next time.
Bye.